Before you deliver anything, you should really be thinking about how you're going to tag your projects with metadata. There are very few platforms that do not read it, and you'll be saving yourself a ton of time if you do this now rather than later. In the library, I'll locate my final project, then select it so that it loads into the inspector. To see the metadata that is currently assigned, I'll click this button to reveal the Share Inspector. These four attributes are the ones that get auto-assigned by Final Cut Pro, but additional metadata fields can be added by clicking this arrow. For my client, it's important to have the date and the episode number included, so I'll choose those items from the list. These purple items are called tokens, and what they do is pull data from the project to make sure it's included in the exported file. So for example, the name token will use the current project as the file name when the file is saved. This can be changed by deleting the token and entering your own. I'll enter Quintessa Harvest Promo 1. The description token is very vague, and it's really meant to be replaced with something more meaningful. I'll enter Winemaker Charles Thomas explains the harvesting process at Quintessa Winery. This description field will be the text that appears for the video when it's uploaded to YouTube or Vimeo. The creator token will pull the name of the currently logged in user on the Mac running Final Cut Pro 10. I usually change this to the name of the production company. The tags field is a bit interesting because this one token actually does quite a lot. As you know, tags are how viewers will find your video amongst the vast sea of content on YouTube. The events tag will pull in all the keywords that are applied to each clip and automatically assign those as searchable metadata. It's better if I show you this. I'll click the share button and choose YouTube. The keyword tokens that appear in this tags area were automatically pulled from all the keywords that were assigned to your clips in the event. Even the event name itself is included as a tag. Now, some of these just may be useful as tags, but you'll find that most of them are just too generic and unrelated to the finished product, so I prefer creating custom ones. To edit the field, I'll go back to the menu and choose Edit Share Fields and select Tags in the sidebar to edit it. The tokens that are currently assigned to that field appear at the top. I'll delete these, then drag the custom name token into the format field and click OK. Let's test this out. I'll go back to the share menu and choose a YouTube share option. This time the tags field is empty, so I don't have to delete any tokens, so that's a good thing. In the tags field, I'll populate it with all the keyword tags related to how I think people will search for my video. I'll type in wine, separated by comma, then some other tags. Harvest, Napa, Merlot, Cabernet, Quintessa, etc. All seems well and good until I cancel out of the window. When I go back to export this, I'll have to re-enter all those tags again. So here's my workaround. If I go back to the browser, you'll notice that I have a notes field for the project, and in it, I've entered all the keywords separated by a comma. So I'll click into the notes field to select them and press Command C to copy. Then paste those notes into the custom tags field. Problem solved. I should point out that after you've exported the movie once, Final Cut Pro does retain all of this metadata, so you won't have to keep re-entering it. This metadata set will now travel with this project, even if you move or copy it to another library. The last bit of metadata I need are the date and episode number per the client's request. And if I plan on creating different versions of this promo, I can save this set of metadata as the default, so that with each new version, I only need to change one or two items before exporting. If you like this tutorial, check out my latest in-depth tutorial on how to edit and deliver a promotional video in Final Cut Pro 10, available at rippletraining.com.